Hey, it's Nate, your political devs guy, and today we'll be doing a Yu-Gi-Oh! Archetypal facelift video on Heraldic Challenger. Oh wait, never mind. Konami already decided to print some new Heraldic Challenger support. Anyways, let's get started. First off, for the new Heraldic Challenger cards coming out of the newest set, I think Dimension Force. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that name has been used before, but I could be wrong. Anyways, first off, we have Heraldic Challenger Knuckle Knife. And it's level 1 Earth Warrior effect monster with 600 attack and 200 defense. And its first effect reads, if you control a heroic monster, except a level 1 monster, you can special summon this card from your hand. It really sucks that it prevents you from from special summoning this card from the hand if you control a level 1. I feel like that's completely pointless and asinine, but whatever. Second effect. If this card is normal or special summoned, you can target one warrior monster you control. The level of that monster or this card becomes the level of the other. But you cannot declare attacks for the rest of this turn except with Xyz monsters. This card is actually fairly good. I would say decent. I just don't like its first effect, which is, again, pretty asinine, and it conflicts with the other level ones in this deck for some strange reason. But whatever, Konami's just Konami, I guess. Next, we have Heroic Challenger Morningstar, and it's a level 4 Earth Warrior effect monster with 1500 attack and 1300 defense. And its first effect reads, if you control two or more warrior monsters, you can special summon this card from your hand. And it's generic warrior support. Nice. Thank you, Konami. Anyways, getting two or more warrior monsters on the field in heroics isn't really that hard. There's a lot of cards that can actually special summon other heroic challenger monsters or heroic champion monsters, and yeah, basically it's just very easy to special summon this card from the hand. And if you're wondering why I have so much trouble just saying their names, is because I'm mixing them up with Heraldic Beasts, plus they're also Heroic Challengers and Heroic Champions, and I'm constantly getting them twisted in my head. And I apologize for that. Second effect. If this card is normal or special summoned, you can add one Heroic Spell Trap from your deck to your hand. Second effect. It's just automatically good. It's a searcher. But the bad part is you're kind of limited to the heroic cards you can add or search, because besides the newest spell card and that one trap card that kind of acts like Magic Cylinder, there's not really any card worth, you know, fetching off of this effect. I guess besides Heroic Chance, but Heroic Chance is, I mean, you're most likely not going to be closing out games with that card anytime soon. Third effect is, if this card is in your graveyard and you have 500 or less life points, yay. You can special summon this card from your hand, but negate its effects. So, this is a free level 4 body, but at the same time, Thousand Blades does it better. But it is what it is. Next, we have Heroic Champion Klamath Solius. Not good at pronouncing names. And it's a rank 4 Light Warrior Xyz effect monster with 2500 attack and 2000 defense. And it basically has the Utopia stats. Nice. Anyways, it requires two level 4 warrior monsters. First effect, monsters your opponent controls cannot target other monsters for attacks. Alright. Second effect, you can pay life points so that you only have 500 left. At the start of the battle phase this turn, the attack of one face-up monster you control becomes doubled.
Hey, that's pretty good!
Third effect reads, when an attack is declared involving a monster, an opponent's monster, you can detach one material from this card, then target one face-up monster your opponent controls. This card gains attack equal to that monster's until the end of this turn. Also pretty nice. And for the last 6Es, it's a rank 1. And it's called Heroic Champion Jargnite. I'm not going to try to pronounce that. And it's level 1 Light Warrior, exceeds effect monster with 700 attack and 1800 defense. And it requires two level 1 Warrior monsters. First effect reads, the first time each Warrior monster you control would be destroyed by battle or card effect each turn, it is not destroyed. Second effect, you can detach two material from this card, then target one level slash rank 4 warrior in your graveyard, special summon it, and if you do, this card gains attack equal to that monster's original attack. Which is pretty nice, because it could also help you swarm the field with heroic challengers and champions, and also deliver OTKs. And the third effect reads, when an attack is declared involving an opponent's monster, you can gain life points equal to half its attack. Still pretty risky since you're lowering yourself down to 500, but whatever. I mean, you're not really going to be doing that all the time. You just have one card that allows you to do it, and one card that relies on you having 500 or less at life points. And lastly, we have their Warrior Returning Alive and Rhoda crammed into one card. And that card being Heroic Envoy. And it's a normal spell card that reads, first effect, add one heroic monster from your deck to your hand. Second effect, and here we go. If you have 500 or less life points, you can banish this card from your graveyard and target one heroic card in your graveyard added to your hand. It doesn't specify that you can't add this card back to your hand if you have another copy of it in the grave, and you can just fetch any of your heroic cards from the graveyard. But you have to have 500 or less life points, and you should know how I feel about that. Anyways, it's been me, your boy Blue Gatsuga, and tell me what you guys think about these new cards, and I'm out.